indeed database DB. It actually created a database for me. Hello everyone, my name is Evgeny and welcome to my channel. Today I wanted to try out the new tool from OpenAI called ChatGPT. I've already experimented with it and I was pretty impressed with the results. In this video, I will try to generate a new page for my blog and share my thoughts on whether it could potentially replace the work of a human developer. For this experiment, ChatGPT will generate a front-end with a working subscribe input and a back-end endpoint. The endpoint will receive an email from the front-end and save it to the SQLite database. All of this will be created solely using ChatGPT. What is ChatGPT? ChatGPT is a type of artificial intelligence that is able to generate human-like text. It is trained using a large amount of text data, which allows it to learn the patterns and structures of human language. When given an input, ChatGPT uses this knowledge to generate a response that is relevant to the conversation. This makes it useful for tasks such as simulating conversation with a human, language translation, and text generation. ChatGPT is also pretty good at generating working programming code. With that in mind, here's me using ChatGPT. So, let's go. I already started the server. I created a folder called subscription. That's all I did. And we can start asking questions. Can you create a Next.js page with an email subscription form? That's all I ask. Yes, you can create a Next.js page with email subscription form. Okay, it did. Handle submit, do something with the email, such as send it to a server or database. That's what I need. What is that? Subscribe to a newsletter. Oh, it wants to, I see. But we can ask it, can you combine those two components into one page? Yes. Nice. Okay. Perfect. We can use just this. See? Well, not really. Can you style it using a styled component? Style components and make it pretty. Yes, you can. It does it. What? Okay. Let's try it. If I go to this, copy it here, save. There are no errors. Good. Well, there are errors. It didn't include the React. Okay. Such a mistake. Rookie mistake. You didn't import React. Shame on you. You're correct. I forgot to import React in the example I provided. Oof. In order to use a Next.js page, you need to import the React package at the top of the file. Here's an updated example that imports React. Okay, copy, paste, save. No errors. About page. Subscription? I forgot the name. Ooh, nice. Whoa. Okay. So, can I put anything here? Subscribe. Can I put anything else? Ooh, it actually does the validation for you. Okay, perfect. Let's move on. Let's now work with the SQLite database. Can you create a Next.js endpoint that will receive a post request with email and save it in the SQLite DB? Don't forget to initialize the DB for me. Okay. By running SQLite 3 DB database DB, next you will need to create a table to store the email address. You can do this by running the following SQLite statement. Let's add a new yarn add SQLite 3. I guess we need that. It didn't tell me to add it. Okay, we added SQLite 3. Now we need to say SQLite. SQLize DB, database DB. Okay. SQLite3, database DB. Yes, yes, yes. I need that. I'm not writing it myself. Did I create something? It did. Database DB. It actually created a database for me. Will this work though? Will this work? So it's a post request. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, let's see. WebStorm. I get it. Sub. Okay. Save. Database. Database DB. Then it uses DB run. Status send. Email set. Okay. Postman. I created this request. Let's just send it. Email address saved successfully. What? I mean, I bet it wasn't too complicated, but I'll be honest. This would take me some research to do. Insert into emails, email. Yeah, I'm not that good with SQLite or SQL for that matter. Okay, that's cool. Now, I reload the page, so I lost the context, unfortunately, of the previous component that it created. Well, we can just copy and paste it, right? We have this command A, command C. Can you use this newly created endpoint in this code and just copy the whole thing? That would be insane if it can. To use the newly created Next.js endpoint in the code you provided, you can modify the handle submit function to send a post request to the endpoint with an email address entered by the user. Here's an example of how you could do this. Okay, yeah, sure. Well, let's save email. It didn't know the endpoint name, so I'll give it to it. It just didn't know it because I created the file. So it doesn't know that it is actually called sub. So it want me to import and update the handle submit, which we do have here, to use this. Okay, I'll just update this. That's not a problem. Okay, all right. Can you add the error handling to the previous code? I even made the mistake in previous. Come on. Will it understand what I'm talking about? Sure. Okay, handle submit. Well, it kind of didn't. No. I'm not gonna accept that. Why no? I need it inside that code. So I need to copy it. It didn't understand. So I'll copy the code, and then I say, can you add a error message handler for this Next.js component? And just copy the whole thing. Will it be too much for it? Handle submit set error, and it has error. Yes, it actually did. It actually bloody did. I just copied the whole thing. Okay, the moment of truth. Does it work? Go to blog post. Well, reload the page. Can we say hello at gmail.com? Subscribe. Did it do anything? Or we didn't provide a success? We didn't provide a success. Okay, we'll just copy the whole thing again. And we will ask it to provide us a success message. Can you add a success message to this Next.js page? Let's see. Because when we click submit, we need to know if it works, right? Let's see. And success, set success email address saved successfully, and where it adds it right underneath the error message. So let's see if it actually works. Save, no errors, okay, good. hello@gmail.com, subscribe. Email address saved successfully. Just to make sure everything actually worked, I will open the DB Navigator and actually open the database. Browse data. Here you go. It actually worked. I didn't write a single line of code. Nothing. I didn't write a single... Well, I'm lying. I corrected it with the API call because it didn't know. This is insane. This is insane. Am I recording? Yes, I am recording. Well, thank you guys. That was fun. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. So I've attempted to generate a new page for my blog. As you can see, it was pretty good. Managed to get a working solution. Though, as you saw, I had to understand the code I'm writing. The exception would be working with database, which wasn't that complicated to begin with. I think ChatGPT is a great tool, but I'm not sure if it will be able to fully replace the work of a human developer. While the technology behind creating a new page using AI may be impressive, there are many nuances and complexities involved in software development that may be difficult for machine to replicate. Ultimately, I think AI has the potential to assist developers in their work, but in the near future it will unlikely be able to completely replace the creativity and critical thinking skills of a human. Thank you for watching. I'm pretty new on YouTube, so please consider supporting my channel by liking this video and subscribing. Bye.